Hey guys, Sifu, Jason, Greenville Academy Martial Arts. Thank you for watching. We do read our comments, and one of you guys out there had a wonderful suggestion for a back drills for those of you stuck in lockdown of sand in especially California, and you just can't get out and train with people. So what's a good way to use a heavy back for some Wing Chun training? So we read that. That's a great topic for a video. I would have thought of that on my own, but you know, I just want to give people, the little people out there, the credit for it. But seriously, thanks for the suggestion. And just go ahead and, you know, you got another suggestion, something you'd really like to see us address, we'd love to help you. So I know everyone's struggling out there with not being able to train live. Okay, heavy bag. A lot of Wing Chun students use the wall bag for the straight punch. And the wall bag's great. Everything has a pro and a con. Look at everything like a prescription, right? Everything has a drawback. So one thing that the wall bag can't really do is give you the ability to move around a lot. Now, I'm going to bring you to the second point, is that a great reason for Wing Chun people to use a heavy bag is because it teaches you how to function in non-contact range. So much of Wing Chun is about, I've got some kind of contact bridge with them, and so therefore, I have some defensive coverage because I've got my hands in a guy, in a clinch. Well, when you're in free movement range, you don't have any accountability of his offense, his bridge, unless you're mobile. So it just becomes very, very important. And a lot of us will go out there and just, you know, from center, and that's pro and a con. Those are great punches, the same punches, right? They're great. However, your chin's up. And people, when they're not in contact, especially, they're gonna be punching around the corner, a lot of hooks and overhands. How do we deal with those shots when we're using Wing Chun? Because we are open for them. So just because we think maybe they're not the most scientific weapons doesn't mean we don't have to account for them. So the best way to look at the heavy bag is as an opponent. So I want to use this as an opportunity to work my defensive offense, my offensive defense. Here we go. I'll throw a couple of shots. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get off the line. I'm going to assume my opponent is throwing an overhand right at me. So I don't want to come in, bang, and get nailed. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to come over to the corner. Notice what I did. A lot of times, and I was just talking to Sifu Aaron about this before we shot the video, and he's doing this a lot in his classes, make sure people have a hand here, and instead of just dropping back and waiting for the move, he gets them moving as they pull the hand back. There's a great way to look at this drill, is get off the line and try to get contact control of a guy. So you can obviously imagine if I'm punching and instead of recovering like this, I'm recovering like this. Now a lot of boxers, we use head movement. Nothing wrong with head movement. We're just doing this to get to the corner with footwork. Okay, so I'm not standing here waiting for a receipt. I'm getting over. You'll notice the footwork is very similar to section 3 on the wooden dummy. I'm just stepping over and I can hit from the corner, so I've got some contact. Now maybe he's moving or whatever, but the idea is I want to get off the line. I don't want to be standing right in front of him, because unlike Wing Chun people in our class, they're not trained to stay here in the pocket. A non-Wing Chun fighter, he starts throwing a chain punch at him and he'll be dropping shots. So we want to account for that. The first big line is watching that overhand right. Now I can just reverse this because there could be a left hand coming. I could just go, in this case, when I'm punching, and go this way. Or one, two, three, this way. Depends on where my feet were. I'm not gonna get too technical here, but one, two, over. This hand's coming back. Now the other thing you'll notice I'm doing is I'm taking small steps while I'm swinging, while I'm punching. So you can still be very mobile while you're working the back. You'll notice a lot of boxers get bad habits, which is why in boxing classes, our coaches are very careful not letting guys do this. Just hanging out in front of the bag. Very bad habit. We want to make sure we're mobile and we're alive and we're moving as we're going, as we're firing as we're moving. So that's one big thing. Now another way I can go, and I can go out. Notice what I did this time. Instead of going over to my right, over to my left, I go back to my right and over. Notice because of the corner I'm covering, I'm using that cover. I'll do it facing you this way, go back this way. Again, a guy slips, he's firing a right hand at me. I'm stepping out to cover that. I like this angle too because the guy's likely to miss me and maybe punch my elbow. And if he punches my elbow, unless he's a Hulk, his hand's probably busted. Okay? Thinking once again, that's part of the recovery. You don't wait and then move because that's a critical second. That punch is probably already on its way. You've probably already blocked it with your face. So make sure, okay? And you can come back after me. So I can go to my left. I can go to my right. Now notice I'm not just standing here hitting the back mindlessly. That's okay to warm up with and cool down with, have some fun with, put some music on, you know, listen to something that really gets you going, you know, but I almost told you what music I listen to, but you don't want to hear that. You should guess. That should be a thing. You should guess what music does Sifu Jason listen to.
That's in the comments.
Anybody gets it, you get a free Teachable course. Okay. Like anybody gets it, you get a free Teachable course. There you go. Of course, never mind. All right. So I get you decide. Another thing to do is go straight back. You want to be careful going straight back because, you know, obviously people can keep coming forward. You don't want to go back mindlessly and just keep running backwards. You clearly always want to get off at angles, but going straight back can come in handy. You know, like a car without reverse is a bad car. You need it. You don't need it as often as you need going forward and drive, but, you know, this is what you're doing. This is a very good catch-all defense. Now, nothing wrong with doing that. Nothing wrong with both hands up. But what the point of this video and the point of this kind of training is to mix these things up and make sure you have an offensive defense, that you're not very one-dimensional. My camera guy's smiling, so I don't know. Still thinking about the music?
Yeah.
Okay, still thinking about the music. trying to hear it in his head. But okay, but seriously, so you get those other angles. Another one that's very, very helpful, and I'll give you one more, and that is to assume that this guy tries to go underneath your punches and you can defend against the takedown. Okay? And that's one great way to defend against that without having a sprawl, is to make sure you can make that transition from your striking to your takedown defense. Remember, he's gonna have to come underneath you, or he's gonna have to come over the top or around the corner when you're throwing straight punches. Put that into your bag drills and you're gonna have a much better workout. You're gonna notice you're kind of tired because you're moving more. This is, this is the hallmark of why people have gas problems when they're boxing. It's because they're not using their legs the way they'd have to be using it in a real fight. So this will teach you better fight endurance because you're always in position. Your legs are always under you and moving. So it's more combat level conditioning. If you can do one good round of this for three rounds, going at a pretty good clip, you're in pretty good shape and you'll be ready for a fight. This brings me to a thing. I've had a lot of Wing Chun people, many of whom I love, and they're great people, great Wing Chun guys, say to me, well, good thing we do Wing Chun. The fight will be over in 2 or 3 seconds, so I don't have to worry about being in shape. It's like, that's like a sniper saying, good thing I only need one bullet. You know, that's just not a good idea. The demands on you, on your whole system are such that you should be as good a shape as possible, in particular, just for your own health, you know? So you get out here, you don't have to do this full speed all the time because that will give you some bad form, but you know, make sure you're being quick and you're being cognizant, consistently conscientious of your defensive responsibilities. Because yes, Wing Chun, before you have full contact with somebody and control over them, and even when you do, they're still breaking free, you still have to move and evade things. You need to be able to move in either direction. You know, inside left, inside right, back left, back right, straight back. You have to be able to defend a low line, high line, all of that. And this will be a great way to do that and keep yourself from getting too one-dimensional so you can apply this when you need it. Okay, so if you're stuck in lockdown of sand, wherever that is, if you're in California, we're with you, right? But In all sincerity, hope this helps. Let me know if you have any questions. Let me know if you can guess what music I'm listening to and I'm working out. And we'll catch you next time. Please click the like and subscribe button, the notification bell, all that jazz. You probably heard this by now. And we'll see you later.